Good afternoon. I declare the convocation open.
On behalf of the students, faculty, and staff of IIT Madras and the Board of Governors, I welcome each and every one of you to this August gathering. Chief Guest Padma Bhushan Professor Manjul Bhargava, Chairman Board of Governors IITM Dr. Pavan Goenka, members of the Board of Governors, members of the Senate, graduates, distinguished invitees, colleagues, and students. On the day of the 52nd Convocation, I'm proud to report that we are crossing another milestone. We are awarding more than 2,000 degrees in a single year for the first time. The number of PhD degrees awarded has increased by 18% to 212 this year, crossing 200 again for the first time. Our full complement of nearly 800 UG and dual degree students, after the capacity increase effected between 2008 and 10, graduates today. The Institute published last year its strategic plan for 2014-20, wherein our targets have been spelled out for all the activities that inform life and work at the Institute. I now share with you some snapshots of our achievements during the academic year 2014-15 with reference to this plan. A key plan objective is the revision of our UG curriculum to permit the students more choices in the courses they take. This has become imperative in a fast-changing world where aspirations are themselves moving targets. In the new curriculum that comes into effect from the oncoming academic year, the students will be given the latitude to choose on average 40% of their courses. Students can thus pursue newly discovered passions or upgrade to a dual degree program, stay on for an MS in entrepreneurship, or simply sample interesting courses across various disciplines. An ever-increasing number of master's students are discovering the excitement of research at IITM. In 2014-15, a total of 59 students upgraded to the PhD program, while 73 high achievers were admitted to the PhD program directly after their bachelor's programs. A further 33 industry professionals also enrolled for their PhDs, indicating a healthy growth in our industry interaction. Overall, the PhD intake per year has crossed our planned target of 80% of the faculty strength, putting us on course to achieving the PhD graduation target set for 2020. Our intense transnational collaborations have resulted in the formalization of several joint doctorate supervision agreements, including one that was signed with the president of Purdue University during his visit here in November 2014. Four more joint doctoral program agreements were signed in 2014-15 to add to the existing four. The new ones are with the University of Melbourne, University of Technology Sydney, and Curtin University, all in Australia, and with the University of Duisburg, Essen, in Germany. In 2014-15, our faculty and research scholars have published 1,089 papers in reputed international journals and 105 in reputed national journals, representing a sharp growth of 30% over the last year. They've also presented 533 research papers in international conferences and 153 in national conferences, again demonstrating a staggering growth of more than 50%. These are harbingers of the scorching pace being set by our growing band of research scholars and faculty, leading to a sharp uptick in our international research profile. IIT Madras has come to be known not only for its academic research, but for the transformative large-scale technologies developed in its multidisciplinary research centers that impact lives of ordinary citizens throughout our country. Development of innovative, scalable, frugal, sustainable, and affordable solutions for national challenges in housing, water, energy, healthcare, transportation, and education is one of the key objectives of our strategic plan. In 2014-15, we made impressive strides in this regard. After successful pilot trials in four states, the revolutionary uninterrupted DC power supply technology developed by our Center for Decentralized Power Systems is now being deployed for city-scale trials in Sasaram, Bihar, with 1 lakh homes, and in Lakhimpur in Assam, with 5,000 homes. The glass fiber reinforced gypsum technology for affordable, sustainable, and rapid housing is being pursued as a key enabler to meet India's Housing for All target by the year 2022. The Center of Excellence in Urban Transport has deployed an intelligent bus tracking and information system for trial on three arterial roads of Chennai that surround our campus. A wireless health monitoring system to observe the fitness of railway bridges remotely has been deployed at Nagari Bridge in Andhra Pradesh. The National Center for the Safety of Heritage Structures, the only one of its kind in the country, has done yeoman work this past year for the rehabilitation of the Kedarnath Temple and conducted rapid structural assessment and developed temporary stabilization designs for monuments in Nepal immediately after the earthquake. The center is also currently assessing the structural health of the official residence of our visitor, the President of India. The thematic unit of excellence on water has developed in 2014-15, deployed in 2014-15, I'm sorry, an additional 350 units of Amrit, the nanomaterials-based drinking water purification technology developed by it, that are serving over 4 lakh rural people in the arsenic-affected areas of India. IIT Madras is now a full member of the compact muon solenoid CMS experiments of CERN. Around 30 ambulances for transporting newborn babies are deployed in Tamil Nadu based on the design and technical specifications developed by our Healthcare Technology Innovation Center. 9 projects are underway at the Indo-German Center for Sustainability on diverse problems in wastewater treatment, land use, distributed renewable energy generation, biofuels, and air pollution. The research is being undertaken jointly by our faculty and 13 visiting German scientists and is funded equally by the Indian and German governments. The TTK Center for Rehabilitation Research and Device Development, set up with a generous grant from the TTK Group, was inaugurated by Sri T.T. Jagannathan, distinguished alumnus of IIT Madras. An incubation center for industrial automation and instrumentation and automobile engineering has been set up with support from the Ministry of Labor and Employment. The Institute undertook a new initiative in coordination with the government of Tamil Nadu to take the benefits of our research efforts to the community. Housing and construction technology, water treatment and pollution control, data mining and GPS-based solutions, solar power technologies, information networks, and healthcare technologies were identified as priority areas. Several academic distinctions, honors and awards, fellowships of academies and professional societies, and memberships on editorial boards of journals have been bestowed on our faculty, staff, and students in recognition of their academic achievements during the current year. Notable among the awardees are Dr. Sheikh Farooq Ali, who won the INA Young Engineer Award, Professors Rama Shankar Verma, elected fellow of NAS, Arun Narsimhan and R.I. Sujit, elected fellows of INAE, Bhaskar Ramamurthi, elected fellow of IEEE, B.S. Murthy, elected fellow of INSA, and T. Pradeep, elected fellow of the Royal Society of Chemistry. 6 of our young faculty, Drs. Ithiyaraja Mani, Shankar Balachandran, Madhu Muttiam, M.N. Jailal Sharma, Krishna Jagannathan, and Jitendra Sangwai, have won the Young Faculty Recognition Award of the Institute for the year 2014. Professor David Koyal Pillai won the Award for Excellence in Teaching for the year 2014-15. Professor T. Pradeep was awarded the Lifetime Achievement R&D Award of IIT Madras, while Professor C. Balaji and Satyanarayan N. Gumadi, the Mid-Career R&D Award, and Drs. Mohan Shankar Sivaprakasam, N. V. Ravi Kumar, and Ramesh Gardas, the Junior Level R&D Award. Karnati Vinod Reddy of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering was awarded the Aditya Birla Scholarship for 2014, while Spandana Raj of the same department won Facebook's Grace Hopper and Google's Anita Borg scholarships. The student team of Sudhirth Vaidya and Abhijit Chunduru from the Engineering Design Department, mentored by Drs. Ganapati Krishnamurthy and M. Ramanathan, won the first place at the Longitudinal Multiple Sclerosis Segmentation Challenge 2015 held at New York. Another student team comprising Rangit, Sriharsha, Sai Gole, Aman Agarwal, Anoop, Kaushik Balaji, Manish Prajapat, Rohit John, and Safar won awards for the best use of advanced manufacturing methods and best use of predictive design and simulation tools in the Student Design Challenge of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers. My full report, which will be on the website and a few published copies are also around, has details of all the awards won by our faculty, students, and staff in the year 2014 and 15. IIT Madras leads in industry collaborations and industry-funded projects. In 2014-15, the Institute received sanction for rupees 64 crores in new projects from industry, representing a 20% rise over the previous year. We are on course to meet our strategic plan target in this respect. The Intellectual Property Management Cell has enabled filing of around 80 patents during the year. By way of seeding new research along risky pathways using its earnings, the Institute has funded several R&D awards, 5 research scholar innovation projects, 22 exploratory research projects with breakthrough ideas, and 2 multidisciplinary team projects that establish a new line of research with potential for creation of new research centers. The IIT Madras Research Park, India's first such university-driven initiative, has reinforced our industry interaction manifold, having reached maximum occupancy levels with around 70 companies and research centers since operations commenced in 2010. The phase two of the IIT MRP with a built-up capacity area of 8.2 lakh square feet is nearly ready for occupation. Saint-Gobain Research India, our anchor client for phase two, Tata Consultancy Services, Confederation of Indian Industry Logistics, Healthcare Technology Innovation Center, Biosciences Incubator, and IIT Alumni Industry Interaction Center have been allotted space covering almost 25% of phase two already. To boost incubation activities as envisaged in our strategic plan, IITM Research Park has allocated an additional 100,000 square feet of space for incubation in phase two, taking the total to 135,000 square feet. The IIT Madras incubation cell enables sharing of resources, including space and infrastructure, access to business support services, mentoring, networking, and access to seed and early stage venture funds, including the IITM Startup Fund, built with contributions from industry and donations from IIT Madras alumni and grants from the Government of India. IITM Incubation Cell's latest addition to its gamut of incubators is the Bio Incubator, with support from BIRAC. IIT Madras is fast emerging as one of the most vibrant startup hubs in the country. Till date, 89 startup companies have been incubated at IITM, of which 29 were set up in 2014-15 alone. Founded by students and faculty of IITM, or external entrepreneurs, leveraging expertise and resources at the institute, with the majority of them located at the research park. Several of them are working in advanced and emerging areas such as IoT, clean energy, water, biomedical devices, healthcare, education, agri-tech, and ICT. Many have graduated with strong infusion of capital from interested majors. IITM is confident of achieving its strategic plan target of at least 20 new companies being incubated on average year after year. The Center for Continuing Education organized programs benefiting about 89,000 participants in 2014-15, resulting in a revenue of around 16 crores. Under the Quality Improvement Program, we have 63 college teachers pursuing their PhDs at IIT Madras. The institute is also assisting engineering colleges in Tamil Nadu and the neighboring states implement their TechWIP 2 programs. In order to meet a long-felt demand from professionals in industry, IIT Madras is launching from this year live online courses in the evening for various industry verticals. We are beginning in 2015-16 with automotive technology, information security, digital communications, and business administration. Students can register for courses at their own pace and earn a master's degree when the required credits have been earned. A trained core team of faculty organizes and conducts at our Teaching Learning Center frequent faculty development programs for teachers at our own institute as well as at the NITs and TechWIP assisted engineering colleges. The National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning, NPTEL, India's largest ICT-based online course program, now has about 875 web and video courses in engineering, science, and technology freely available on the NPTEL website and also through YouTube. With MOOCs gaining momentum in the last few years, NPTEL has embarked on offering online courses through its new portal. It has successfully completed 57 such courses till date. Of the 2.4 lakh students who have enrolled for these courses, 7,500 have been certified in 2014-15 by means of a physically proctored examination. A total of 158 top-ranking students from across the country benefited from IIT Madras's summer fellowship scheme this year. IIT Madras is mentoring two new IITs at Palakkad and Tirupati. The temporary campuses and hostels are ready, and the classes for the first batch of students will commence from August this year. Earlier, IIT Madras had successfully mentored IIT Hyderabad. As part of the Rashtriya Avishkar Abhiyan, a recently launched initiative by MHRD, IIT Madras has been engaged in mentoring and providing in-house training both to the students and teachers of the Kendriya Vidyalaya here on our campus and other government NGO schools in our vicinity through the National Service Scheme and the Center for Social Innovation and Entrepreneurship. IIT Madras has, under the Ishan Vikash program launched by the Prime Minister, mentored 16 students and two faculty members from NITs of the northeastern states of Mizoram and Assam for a month during the year 2014-15. More than 50 new MOUs, all active, were signed during 2014-15 to facilitate student exchanges and faculty collaborations with universities across the globe, taking the total number such currently which are active to 200. Five joint doctorate programs have been launched in partnership with foreign universities in the year under review, four of which I mentioned a little earlier. A 40% increase from 2013-14 has been observed in the number of students electing to take up study abroad programs and research visits. The non-academic staff recognition awards for administrative technical staff members who have been making significant contributions to the Institute by their outstanding and consistently excellent service have been instituted last year. The awardees for 2014-15 are Ms. Vasanti Subramanian, Ms. M. Saraswati, and Ms. Jayashri Sridhar under the administrative category, Mr. K. Trinavakrasu, Mr. Ajay Krishnan, and Mr. S. Arjunan under the technical category, and Mr. N. Yerumalai under the supervisory managerial category. All academic departments and the Institute as a whole were reviewed by external review committees in 2014, many of which had members from leading universities abroad. A plan of action based on the recommendations of the review committees has been evolved. The following initiatives have been undertaken on priority basis. Formation of a curriculum task force and implementation of a flexible BTech dual degree curriculum from the year 2015-16. Performance-based career advancement for senior professors through chair professorships. Mentoring of young faculty. Acquisition of a satellite campus. Improving safety standards in the work environment. And improving maintenance of infrastructure. A major landmark for IITM this year is the generous allotment of 163 acres of land in Thayur village by the government of Tamil Nadu for our satellite campus. Tunga and Bhadra, the two boys' hostels with 732 rooms, have been completed this year. They were inaugurated this morning by our chairman, Board of Governors. The alumni have generously contributed to the construction of the new Cork canteen in the hostel area. Our sports facilities are being significantly augmented to international standards in time for the inter-IIT sports meet, which returns to IIT Madras this December. The modernization of our stadium has been made possible by a generous donation from our distinguished alumnus, Prem Vatsa. As per the two animal censuses conducted in 2014-15, it is estimated that there are about 372 cheetal, 32 black buck, and about 284 macaque on our lovely campus. The past academic year was one of the most successful years for the Center for Innovation, as witnessed by the accolades our team won. Team Amog finished 15th in the International Robo Sub competition at San Diego, while Team Raftar made the lightest and first sub 200 kilogram car and participated in FSAE. An IIT Madras Space Center to assemble the components for small satellites was inaugurated in April 2015, thanks to a generous support of our distinguished alumnus, Dr. Krishna Chivkula. The satellite designed and built by our students over several years and multiple graduating batches is to be placed in a low Earth orbit within the next year. Shastra, the annual technical festival, attained greater heights this year with a leap in footfall and quality workshops. A jewel in the crown of Shastra was the Pledge a Book campaign that helped build libraries for rural schools. Sarang, the cultural festival, celebrated its 40th edition and was themed Out of the World with over 65 events and 5 professional shows. It made history in terms of footfall and sponsorship. In the 50th Inter-IIT Sports Meet, the IITM women's and men's contingent secured the 3rd and 5th places respectively in the general championship. Mr. Praveen Kumar of IITM has been adjudged the fastest in the championship, winning both the 100 meters and the 200 meter dash. Our aquatic team, both men and women, did very well, securing the 1st and 2nd places respectively. Our quiz club members have been crowned champions of the Inter-IIT IIM Nihilanth 2015, the 2nd victory in a row, establishing that our quiz club is among the best in the country. The National Service Scheme Unit, which engages in social service, undertook as many as 30 projects this year, focused on teaching, content generation, and bringing change. An honor code has been formally introduced this year, and the Student Affairs Council members took oath with the honor code for the first time. Mitra, the IITM counseling and guidance service, organized many activities in the past academic year through its professional counselors and as many as 300 trained volunteers. A total of 939 students were placed through the placement office, of whom a large fraction, 61%, joined core engineering companies. In order to enhance student interaction with the companies, an internship office chaired by an advisor has been set up. The key focus of the Office of International and Alumni Relations continues to be to maximize two-way connectivity between the Institute and her alumni. Alumni footfall on campus continues to be high, with involvement ranging from innovation and entrepreneurship initiatives to industry connects. IIT Madras has been honoring with Distinguished Alumnus Awards since 1997. Alumni with outstanding achievements in the areas of entrepreneurship, leadership and management, academia and research, social and technological innovation, and service to humanity at large. The awardees for this year are Dr. Prakash Keshavaya, Lalit Mahajan, Krishna Chivakula, Dr. S. Ramakrishnan, Sekhar Vasan, Ajita Rajendra, Dr. Arumugam Mandiram, Dr. Periyannan Kupuswamy, Dr. R. Srikant, and Dr. Krishna Bharat. 2014-15 was the best year ever for fundraising, with the contributed amount of rupees 23 crores, nearly doubling the previous highest annual intake. The single most notable contribution in 2014-15 was from our board member and distinguished alumnus, Chris Gopalakrishnan, who announced the sponsorship of 3 distinguished chairs in computational brain research, endowed at rupees 10 crores each. A third chair, filled during the year by Professor Ashok Venkatraman from Cambridge University, is in biological systems engineering, endowed by the Mehta Family Foundation of Houston in the Department of Biotechnology, Bhupat and Jyoti Mehta School of Biosciences. For continuing with our effort to scale up fundraising, professionally staffed development offices have been launched in India and the US. An endeavor on the scale of this institute and its entire gamut of activities takes place with the wholehearted participation and support of all stakeholders: our faculty, students and staff, agencies and industries sponsoring R&D and consultancy projects, professionals from other organizations who assist us in various capacities, and our alumni. In particular, I'd like to thank office bearers such as heads of departments, deans, chairpersons, wardens, advisors, and professors in charge of various cells and centers for the selfless work they put in to keep the institute ticking. The institute is grateful to the Ministry of Human Resources Development, Government of India, for its continued and sustained encouragement and support. I also take this opportunity to specially thank the state government of Tamil Nadu for providing IITM with the land for its satellite campus. I wish to thank Dr. Pawan Goenka, our chairman, Board of Governors, for his wise counsel, support, and guidance, enabling us to scale new heights. He has instilled in us a goal-oriented approach to the pursuit of our strategic plan objectives. I take this opportunity to thank outgoing board members, Shri Mohammad Hashim Jadwet and Shri Praveen Kumar, and welcome Dr. Utpal Sharma and Srimati S. Madhumati to the board. I would like to thank our chief guest, Professor Manjul Bhargava, for gracing this occasion. He has been exceptionally gracious in accepting our invitation, even though it has meant traveling to India from the US twice within a month and for the 5th time this year. He need not have gone out of his way, but he has. We are touched by his gesture. You will hear all about his achievements when we read his citation for the honoris causa degree that we are going to bestow on him today. Before I end, I would like to congratulate the prize winners and wish all our graduates happiness, professional success, and fulfillment from a life of service to family and country. God bless you all.